Oh, thank you. I see you in the building. God bless you. User, you need to go to your profile, edit profile, and change your username from user. So I can't attach name with you now. It's showing user from my end. Please.
Instagram, TikTok,
so Bright.
Is heavy. You don't have heavy.
Unbelievable. I hope. Ah, hey. My personal person, though. Hey, this one you. Ah, this your name is very hard for me to pronounce. Bright. Go right down. I'm going to just shut it. Go right down. How are you doing? Thank you. God bless you. God bless you.
How are you doing? Thank you. God bless you. God bless you. How are you doing? Thank you. God bless you.
Waiting the sub. I got you in beauty. You know, it's great damn. Let me just. Okay, you're fine. Fine too. Your face show, your shoes shine, you got dons. Your face show, your shoes shine, you got dons. You know, it is what it is. It is what it is. God bless you. You know, having you here, my heart is beating. My heart is beating. Seeing you here, my heart is beating like this. You know, it's like you are seeing your boss. You got a flow. So it's like this. Of course I fucked up. I got you in the building. Let's go. Hey. Go right down. You are making my day. Share you know, say now that they talk now for TikTok. Now when we day school, we dey wine, you know. Then Unilag. We want, people can wine, eh? You say, guy, how far? You don't read? The person will have read back and front too. And I say, guy, I've not read anything. Hey, how are we going to write this exam like this? If you stay by that, you're on a long thing, no. So I'm no longer in school now. I can't be whining you. You got the flow. So that is how we roll. So I know you will still go live. I know. If you are still on, I'm gonna call you. I hope you will not deny me your face. You got it flow. So maybe as you turn on my this thing, let me just wait 5 minutes for I'll start by 11:10. We have 5 minutes more. Let's use 5 minutes more to hype ourselves. Who is in the building? Drop where you are watching from. Let's give you a shout out. drop where you are watching from. Let's give you a shout out. Yeah, I've not started anything, no solution. I got you in the building. Let's go, let's go. Let's give you Joriman before I start. Oh no, Bright. Okay, I'll just call you Bright. Because the remaining one, my teacher will remove. Bright in the beauty. Guys, grab Bright too. She's amazing. Yes. Let's go. Let's give Doriman. We need to sing Doriman before we... Oh, I got you in the building. T Olaf in the building. I got to play Doriman for my people. I got to play Doriman. You got the flow. Network no sir. Back sitter, I've not started. We've not started at all. We just 4 minutes more. 4 minutes more. 4 minutes more. Yeah, 4 minutes more. Drop where you are watching from. Let's recognize you before you go. When I believe in fast life, but I see it in slow. Oh no, and you see my lifestyle, I got G's in the tub. See many people there outside where they feed man's obo. Oh no, and me a standy defender like Joseph Yobo. My girl say she want Netflix and chill, so I chatty get him a warning. If you fall in love, barely satin. You got your breakfast, I'm not coming. Can you see? Oh, I see you all the way from Sarah. Your face show? God don't. All the way from Germany. Your face show? Your shoe shine. You got don't. That solution. Cyrus Tech Picking. See you. Hi, your me. All the way from Nigeria. We got you. We got you. If you want to take up serious, I do to speed. No fit to resonate. I'm on a different. We are starting by. Then, what is that? When I feel like I'm coming off the right wing, I call to your defender, you no need to tell me. I'm a finesse. You know, send me a muscle. Then, can I go carry go? Oh, solution all the way from Nigeria. Z, easy one. Now you the runner, yeah. Now show you runner. If you don't get money, it's you. If you don't care for it, yes. If I work on my business, I'ma show you you go right. All I care for the night, yeah. If I work on my business, I'ma show you you go right. All I care for the night. Everybody in the building, your face show. Your shoe shine, your face show. Your shoe shine, you got those. Your face show, your shoe shine. So, 1 minute more. Your face show, your face shine. That's our rule. No, we have not started. I just came right now. I can shout. Now it's 10. Enough. Let's start the business of the day. Let's go. Guys, can you see the screen? I think, I don't know. Okay. I think it's clear now. Let the story begin. So let the story begin. This is a simultaneous equation. Having one, the simultaneous equation, where you'll be having one linear, one quadratic equation. One linear, one quadratic equation. So whenever you have something like this, all you got to do is to use substitution method. So you look at the two equations, then you choose the simplest one, so that you make one of the variable subject of the formula. Then you substitute it back to the second equation. Then the remaining one is simplification. So let's go. So we're having equation one, equation two. So equation one is a linear equation. Equation two is a quadratic equation. Now, between linear and quadratic equation, which one is more complex? Which one? Drop in the comment section. Guys, don't forget to share the live as we move on. So which one is more complex? A linear equation and a quadratic equation. So I need some answer in the comment section. Quadratic, yeah, quadratic equation. So which means we are going to make use of the linear equation to find any of the variable and then make it the subject of the formula. So from equation one, where's this one coming from? So from equation one, we say from one. So we're having 2x plus y is equal to 1. Between x and y, which one is the simplest one to make the subject of formula? Between x and y, which one do you think is the simplest one that we can make the subject of formula? Yeah, simultaneous equation that involves one linear, one quadratic equation. Okay, good. So you see that you make y the subject of formula. So if y is the subject of formula, we have 1. When this comes to this, I become negative. Minus 2x. So we call this one equation 3. So now that we know we have made use of equation 1 and we have equation 3, we are left with just only equation 2. So what we now do is to say substitute or put y equals to this in equation 2. So you can write it in two ways. Put y equals to 1 minus 2x into equation 2. So our equation 2 says that x squared plus y squared is equals to 13. So wherever we see y, we are going to place this. This is what we are placing to replace y. So that becomes x squared plus, so that becomes x squared, then plus y, we write 1 minus 2x, but y is having power of 2, so that is 2, equals to 13. Then you need to expand this, so it becomes x squared plus into 1 minus 2x, open bracket, 1 minus 2x, close the bracket, equals to 13. So the remaining one now, I'm just doing simplification. You got it, flow. So now, we have x squared plus 1 times 1, 1. 1 times minus 2s, minus 2s, minus 2s times 1, minus 2s, minus 2s times minus 2, that is 4x squared, equals to 13. So let's arrange according to order. See this, is 4x squared, 1x squared. The total is what? The total is 5x squared. Then we have minus 2s, minus 2s, that is minus 4x. Then we have it plus 1. When you bring 13 to this other side, it becomes minus 13 equal to 0. So you are now having 5x squared minus 4x. Then 1 plus 1 minus 13, that is minus 12, equals to 0. So we are going to use AC method. AC method. And using AC method to do this means that you use the coefficient of x squared to multiply the constant that gives us minus 60. That is 5 times minus 12. That is minus 60. So what are the two numbers? What are the two numbers? What are the two numbers whereby when you multiply it, you get minus 60, and when you add it, you get minus 4. So we can use minus 10 and 6. Minus 10 times 6, minus 60. So minus 10 plus 6. So that will give us minus 4. So I can split this minus 4 into minus 10 plus 6. So that is how we do that. So let's split it and see what we have. Let's split it. So here now we'll be having 5x squared minus 10x plus 6x. You know, by the time you add these two, you will still have this. Then minus 12 equals to 0. So you need to group them 2 and 2. Then you factorize. Something is common. 5 is common because 5 goes in 10. So 5 is common and s is also common. So after that, you have taken 5 and 1x from here. You are left with just 1x. Then minus 5, 10 divided by 5, that is 2. Then we have taken this x beside 10. This is what we are having outside. By the time you open this bracket, you should have what is here. 5x times x, 5x squared. 5x times minus 2, that is minus 10x. Then something is common between 6 and 12, plus is 6. Because 6 goes in 12. So what do we have left? We have taken away 6 from here. We are left with x. Then minus 12 divided by, that is 2. That is 6 times minus 12. You have minus 2. You have minus 12. That is equals to 0. So you are going to take those one outside. Then you pick one of these brackets. So and that will give us, you multiply the coefficient of x squared, which is 5, and the constant, which is minus 12. 5 times minus 12, that is minus 60. That is how I got 60. So now let's pick, we are having 5 outside and 6 outside. That makes it 5s plus 6. Then We are having equal bracket. Just pick any of this of it. So that is s minus 2 equals to 0. So we can say 5s plus 6 equals to 0, or s minus 2 equals to 0. So we have 5s equals to minus 6, s equals to minus 6 over 5, or s equals to 2. So we are having two values now. That is, s is equals to minus 6 over 5 or 2. So now we have gotten value for x. So we have gotten value for quadratic n time. There's no quadratic n time. So now we have gotten value for x and s. Now we need to calculate the value for y. So your initial equation that you make y the subject of formula, we have to go back to that place and just put your value. You know, we said y is equals to this. Let me rewrite it. Said y equals to 1 minus 2s. So when now say when s equals to minus 6 over 5. So what is the value of y? So y will be equals to 1 minus 2 into minus 6 over 5. And that will give y equals to 1 minus 2 times minus 6. That is plus 12 over 5. So this is over 1. By the time you find the LCM, LCM is 5. 1 and 5, 5 times 5, 1. 5 plus 5 cancel 5, 1 times 12. That is 12. You have this as 17 over 5, which will give us 3 whole number, 2 over 5. So that is for that. Then when s is 2, when s is 2, so what do we have? If you, from here again, which says y equals to 1 minus 2x, then y will be equals to 1 minus 2 into 2, s is 2 now. So we have y equals to 1 minus 4, which is equals to minus 3. So that is how we roll. You don't need to divide both sides by 5. I'm just telling you how you get the value. Engineering student sorrow. So you get what I'm saying? I'm just saying a way of finding using factorization method in solving quadratic equation. You got the flow. So is this clear? Continue or repeat from the beginning. Continue or repeat. Okay, continue, Joe, in the building. See you, Joe. I am Linus. I hope it's not only you. Repeat, okay. I remember that, Yesha. Repeat, please, repeat. We're only having 2 repeats in the building. So, I'll rush this one now. I'm going to rush this one. So, listen to it. I'll be very fast with this one. So, from the beginning, I said you should look at the 2 equations, look at the simplest one, and make one of the variable the subject of formula. I'm having equation 1 to be linear equation, and equation 2 to be quadratic equation. So, if that is the case, I can easily make any of the variable in equation 1 the subject of formula. That will be easy for me. Are you getting it? So, are you getting it now? So, now, from here now, if you are making y the subject of formula, it becomes y equals to 1. When this moves to here, it becomes 1 minus 2x. We call this one equation 3. You can now say put equation 3 into equation 2. This is equation 2 that you have not made use of. Are you getting me now? So now, equation 2 says that x squared plus y squared equals to 13. So from here, wherever I see y, this. So it becomes x squared plus into 1 minus 2x all squared, because y is carrying squared. So equals to 13. You need to expand this. So it becomes x squared plus into 1 minus 2x, then 1 minus 2x, then equals to 13. So you open the bracket. So you have x squared equals to x plus 1 times 1, 1. 1 times minus 2, minus 2x. Minus 2x times 1, minus 2x. Minus 2x times minus 2, plus 4x squared. Then that will give you 13. So you have, see this power of 2, power of 2. That is 5 raised to power 2. 5x raised to power 2. So we are having 2 minus 2x minus 2x. That will give us minus 4x. Then we're having plus 1. And when you transfer this to this way, it becomes minus 13 equals to 0. Now we have 5x squared minus 4x minus 1 minus 13. That is 12 equals to 0. Now I said you take the coefficient. You don't need, unless if you want to solve, this question by using completing the square. If you want to solve this question by using completing the square, then you first divide through by the coefficients of s. Since I want to do factorization, I don't want to use completing the square. Then what I need to do is to take the coefficient of s squared and multiply the constant. And that will give me, that is 5 times minus 12. That is minus 60. Minus 60. 60. You got it? So which means I need 2 numbers whereby when I multiply it, I get minus 60. I also need 2 numbers, and when I add the number, I get this center value, which is minus 4. So this is how, this is what we call AC method. AC method. Because this value here is A, while this one is C. You know the center value is B. I hope you are getting the flow. Now, so what I just look at this. 10 and 6, I will get 4. 10 and 6 will give me 60. But how do I place the value? Because I'm having negative here, I have to give the highest value, the bigger value, negative, which is minus 10, then 6. So minus 10 times 6, minus 60. So minus 10 plus 6, that will give me minus 4. So that is why I knew that I'm going to use minus 10 and 6 to replace 4x. So that I want to, you know this term here, you are only having trinomial. You are only having 3 terms here. So I'm finding a way of changing it to 4. So we should use completing the square method. Okay, let's use completing the square method to solve this. So by using completing the square method, so let me clear from here. So let's use completing the square method. We have 5x squared minus 4x minus 12 equals to 0. So let's use completing the square method. Just like that one will take us longer this thing. So you got it. So now let's use completing the square method. So using completing the square method, you need to first separate the constants. So separating the constant, we have 5x squared minus 4x equals to 12. You need to separate the constant. So when you separate the constant, you need to make the coefficient of x squared 1. So how do I make this one 1? Is to divide through by 5. So when 5 cancel 5, we are left with x squared minus 4x over 5 is equals to 12 over 5. Now, the next thing you need to do here now is to add the coefficient of x all squared. Add the half of the coefficient of x squared to both sides. Look at what I'm saying. You add the half of the coefficient of x all squared to both sides. So now, the coefficient of x now is minus 4 over 5. Now, the half of this is multiplied by 1 over 2. All squared. So this is the term you are adding to both left and right. You are adding to both left and right. Are you getting it now? Ayomi, let me make you a co-host. Ayomi, if you see any rubbish, this thing, just mute the person. So, Ayomi, Ayo_me. Okay, I just made you a co-host. So if you have seen anybody dropping how to make Yahoo, just remove them. I've been repeating this all this while, that we are trying to see how the people that are sitting for jam. Kemzi Bank, we just started. So we are trying to use a completing the square. I said once you transfer the constant, you make the coefficient of x squared 1. And once you are done with that, you will now look at this value, the coefficient of x, the half of it, all square, is what we are going to write to both sides. We are going to add to both sides. So this one is going to give us 2 here 1, 2 here 2. We're having minus 1 over 5, all square. So this is what we are adding to both sides. Minus 1 over 1. Okay, sorry, not 1. 2. Minus 2 over 5, that is what we are, 2 here 1, 2 here 2. So we are adding minus 2 over 5 to both sides. So that is what we are going to add to both sides. Minus 2 over 5. So this is how you do it. We are having x squared minus 4x over 5. This is what we are adding to both sides. Minus 2 over 5 all square. Then we are also adding into this side 2 over 5 plus into minus 2 over 5 all square. So which means why we are adding it to both sides is that. So the why we are adding it to both sides is because if you arrange this, they will cancel each other. If you bring this one to this place, it become negative and they become zero. So now by expansion, we are saying this one is carrying square, this one is carrying square. Just put them together. This is negative. Had it been is positive, you write positive here. But it's negative, you write negative 2 over 5, all raised to power 2. If you should expand this, you will get this. If you expand this, you will get this. So it's equals to 12 over 5, then plus minus 2 times minus 2, 4 over 5 times 5, that is 25. So here we go. we have s minus 2 over 5 all square is equals to the LCM is 25. 5 in 5 in 25, that is 5. 5 times 12, that is 60. Plus what? 5 cancel 5. We have what? We have 4. So we are having s minus 2 over 5 all square will be equals to 64 over 25. Then you find the square root of both sides. 2 over 5 is equals to plus or minus. Whenever you are solving quadratic equation, you are using completing the square method. So what you, this method go far. Yes. So what you need to do, what you need to do is to include, whenever you introduce square root, you need to introduce plus or minus, plus or minus. So we are having plus or minus square root of 64 over 25. So now from here now, I believe you can see from here, okay. So s minus 2 over 5 will be equal to plus or minus square root of 64 is 8 and square root of 25 is 5. So you can make s the subject of formula. We have this minus will change to positive. That is 2 over 5 plus or minus 8 over 5. So all you need to do now is to now split plus or minus so that you can get two value for x. So s can now be equal to 2 plus 8 over 5 or 2 minus 8. Okay, you know, let me, if this is what you have, but let me do it one by one. 2 over 5, then plus 8 over 5. 2 over 5, 8 over 5. So if you collect terms, 5 is the small, is the LCM. So that it will just be 2 plus 8. 5 in 5, 1. 1 times 2, 2. 5 in 5, 1 times 8. So the same thing with this one. We are having 5. That is 2 minus 8. So x now will be equal to 10 over 2, which is s equals to 5. Oh, sorry. S over 5, which means s is equals to 2. Or 2 minus 8, that is minus 6 over 5. I hope you got it flow. I hope you got it flow. For s over 5, nothing do. This is what I say now from here. You see, you pick the one that has square. If you expand this, I change. Look at something. You see this s square minus 4s over 5 plus into minus 2 over 5 all square. You see these two value. These two value will give you s minus 2 over 5 all square. So if you should solve this, yes, if you should solve this, if you should solve this, this, if you should expand this. So that is how we roll. So let's solve the second one before we go to jam. Let's solve the second one. So we're having 3x plus 5y equals to 29, equation 1, and sy equals to 12, equation 2. Now, between equation 1 and equation 2, which one is more complex? Between equation 1 and equation 2, which one is more complex? More complex. And we have used the factor method now. I believe everybody understands that one. We have solved it. It's because they said we should repeat. Somebody say equation 2. Between equation 1 and equation 2, which one is complex, more complex? So 2, okay. Since we know everybody is going for 2, 2 is the complex. So we will make the, look at the second equation. Yes, we look at this equation and make any of these the subject of formula. We are good to go. We can make y and we can also make s. So we say from 1 now, we can say 3x is equals to 29 minus 5y. So s equals to 29 minus 5y over 3. So equation 2, equation 3. You see now, so whenever I see equation S in equation, whenever I see S in equation 2, I place this. Now let's go. So from here now, from here, I have, this is X. So I have to put 2y minus 5y over 3, then into, because we are having y here, y, which is equals to 2. Now we can now open bracket. We have 29y minus 5y squared, isn't it? Over, because this will multiply the numerator alone, over 3, is equals to 2, is equals to 12. So this is over 1. When you cross multiply, you have 29y minus 5y squared is equals to 36. That is 3 times 12, 36. So let's see, we are using our, we are having minus 5y squared plus 29y minus 36 equals to 0. You get the same answer. You can also multiply through by negative. So you can say 5y squared minus 29y plus 36. So that is what you have, equals to 0. Now this one is having a bigger number, so you can just use your formula straight. S equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. So which is equals to, our b is minus 29. Minus times minus, it turns to positive. Then plus or minus square root of minus 29 squared minus 4 times a. Our a is 5 times 5. Then our c is 36 times 36. Then divided by 2 times a. A is 5 times 5. So I'm going to use calculator here now. So we are having S equals to 29 plus or minus. What do we have? I'll just press everything. So you listen to me as I will use calculator to press everything. So I will say, this is how I'm going to press it. That is 29 minus 29 times minus 29. That is 29 squared. So minus, open bracket, 4 times 5 times 36, close the bracket, is equals to square root of answer, is equals to 11 over 10. So we can split it now. We can say 29 plus 11 over 10, or 29 minus 11 over 10. So we have S equals 40 over 10, or 18 over 10. So we have equals to, is that 18? 9, yes. So we have 4 or 2 here, 9, 2 here, 5. So this is what we have. I hope you are getting the flow. Now, don't forget here that we are having S equals to this. So let's calculate the value of, this should be Y. The value I'm getting should be Y, not X. You know, this, everything here is Y. So we're having Y. So now, when Y is 4, so S will be equal to 29 minus 5 times 4 over 3. So S will be equal to 29 minus 20 over 3. So that is 9 over 3. So therefore, S is 3. So when S is 9 over 5, is 9 over 5. So from here, we have S is equal to 29 minus 5 into 9 over 5 divided by 3. So S will be equal to 29 minus 5, cancel 5, we are left with 9 over 3, which is 20 over 3, which is 18, that is 6. 6 is whole number, 2 over 3. I hope you got the flow. You know, from where? I've told you. Is it from the one I've cleared off? You know, I multiply negative, multiply true by negative. Should I repeat it? Should we repeat the value? Okay, see, let's repeat it again. You get what we did. Now look at something. Look at it. We are making s the subject of formula here. So we're having 3x is equals to 29 minus 5y. Then s will be equals to 29 minus 5y divided by 3. Isn't it? I hope you agree with me on this. So now let's go. So from here, we are having sy equals to 12. So wherever I see x, I will replace it with this. So I'm having 29 minus 5y over 3, then multiply by y equals to 12. So let's open bracket. You have 29y minus 5y squared. So you're in cross multiply equals to 36. That is 3 times 12. 36. So you can now say 29y minus 5y squared minus 36 equals to 0 when you bring this one here. So let's write it in order. Minus 5y squared plus 29 minus 36 equals to 0. This is where you are asking me whether it's negative or not negative. So what I'm now saying now is that is to multiply true by negative. If you make any of the equation one the subject of formula, you will make it more complex. So this one is the simplest one. So if you use a is 29y. So 29y. If you make any of s or y in equation two, if you make it the subject of formula, it's going to be more complex. So that is how we roll. I just hope you are not referring to me and Lib Z. So that is how we roll. So if you multiply through, we have 5y squared minus 29y plus 26 plus 36 equals 0. Multiply through by negative. So negative will cancel this. This one become negative, this one become positive, equals to 0. So we still arrive at the same thing now. So which one were you saying that minus 29 or 9? So this is the equation I use. I hope you got the flow. Hope you got the flow. So I said, instead of me to be racking my brain on which two, because by the time you multiply 5 times 36, you get a bigger number. So instead of racking your brain, just use the quadratic formula that says y equals to, because we are having in terms of y equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac over 2a. You got it flow. So you got it. Joel, which part you don't understand? This is the formula for quadratic I hope the story is clear now. Shall we continue? So shall we continue now? So now let's go. So from here now, this is our A, this is our B, and this is our C. So B is minus 29. So Y equals to minus times minus, that will give us plus. That is 29, plus or minus, square root of our B squared, that is 29, minus 29, minus 29 all squared, minus 4. A is what? A is 5, times 5. C is 36, times 36, times 36. I hope you can see that. There's 36, all over, everything over 2A, 2 times 5. So Y equals to 29 plus or minus. So listen to me again. I'm going to press my calculator and get the answer at the same time. Yes, now, are you not seeing 5 square? It's 5 square we are seeing here now. So now let's see how you say 29 times 29. You can do 29 square or 29 times 29. Then you press equals to, you now press minus, after you have done 29 times 29, this equals to, you press minus, you on the calculator, you press open bracket. Once you press open bracket, is it showing? Okay, I believe you can see. That is minus 29 times minus 29. That's giving me 841. Then minus, I just press minus for my calculator. So I will just minus, where is 4? Minus 4, I hope you can see. Minus 4 times A, which is 5, times 36. 36. You see, you close the bracket. See, this is the closed bracket. Then equals to, so this is the answer. You just press square root of answer. Square root. You press answer on your calculator. See the answer. You press answer on your calculator. So equals to, you now press equals to, so you see it, the answer is 11. So that is how you press it. So this is 11 over 5 times 5, that is 10. You need to now split this. 11 plus, 29 plus 11. 29 over 10, or 29 minus 11. 29 minus 11 over 10. So Y will now be equals to 29 plus 11, that is 40 over 10. So Y is equal to 4, or 29 minus 11, that is 18 over 10, which we can say is 9 over 5. I hope you get the flow. I hope you get the flow now. So now from our equation, we can now make, we can now say, no, this is our X here. So this is the value of Y. So when Y is 4, so we put it here. So S will be equal to 29 minus 5 times 4 over 3. So this is when Y is 4. So S will be equal to 29 minus 20 over, that is 5 times 4, 3. So S will be equal to 9 over 3, which is 3. I hope you get that. I hope you get that. Now, when S is 9 over 5, where Y is 9 over 5, so S will become, from here, 29 minus 5, Y now is 9 over 4, 9 over 4, 9 over 5 rather, then divided by 3. So you have S equals to 29 minus, you see that 5 cancel 5, you are left with 9 over 3, which is 20 over 3. That is 6 whole number, 6 whole number, 2 over 3. So that is how, I hope the story is clear now. I hope the story is clear this time. So we shall continue our jam question now. We shall continue, guys. Kindly partake, share the live. We can continue our jam question now. Jam question in the moment. Jam question in the moment. So we continue from where we stopped yesterday. Jam question in the moment. And the moment, de água, cheio de mama. Thanks for sharing the life. I got you in the building. Got you in the building. Should we continue with Jab or you want to solve more example on linear and quadratic simultaneous equation? Continue with Jab or solve more example on the simultaneous. Okay, I see you. So where we stop at number 38. The question says, what value of S? What value of X, what value of X will make the function y equals to S into 4 minus X a maximum. So I believe if you have been attending this class for over 2 weeks now or a week plus now, when you see this type of thing now, you should know what to do next. What to do next is what? Is to differentiate. When you differentiate, you equate to zero. Whether you are finding maximum or minimum, is the same thing. You differentiate and you equate it to zero. So now, if y equals to s into 4 minus x, 4 minus s. So let's open the bracket. We have 4x minus s squared. So when you find the y ds equals to, this will give you 4 minus 2 times the coefficient, that is 2. You subtract one from this. This is the result. But because you want to find the minimum value, whether it is minimum or maximum, your value will tell you which one to pick. Now, you turn this one to zero. You call it at the turning point. So it's equal to zero. So 4 minus 2x. So when you bring this one here, it becomes plus 2s. That is 2s equals to 4. So s equals to 4 over 2. So which is 2. So the value of x that will give you the maximum value of y is 2. So that is how we rule. Repeat. Okay. Majority carry the vote. Majority. Which part you don't understand? Is it the differentiation part? Different. You know our basic this thing now. If y equals to, let me just say an, the y, the s will be n x n minus 1. This is the basic step we follow in differentiating. Are you getting me now? So you bring the n to multiply the coefficient of s, then you subtract one from it. You have differentiated. I hope you got it. So now let's do it again. Let's open bracket. We have x, 4x, that is s times 4. 4s minus s times s, s squared. So the y, the s of this will be equal to, when you differentiate this, 1 times 4, that is 4. When you say s is having 1 before, minus 1, that is s raised to power 0. Anything raised to power 0 is 1. That is why we're having it as 4. So now, when you now differentiate this, become 2 times the coefficient of x, that is minus 2. Then x, you subtract 1 from this, it turns this one to 1. I said this one, for you to find the minimum value or maximum value, it's going to happen at a turning point. You know when you draw your graph, so you know you can either have a U or inverted U. Are you getting me now? When you plot a quadratic graph, when you plot a quadratic graph, you can either have a U or an inverted U. So if that is the case, on this one, you find the minimum value of Y is at this point. This is the minimum value of Y at a particular value of X. This is why they are asking you to find the minimum value. So here, they will ask you the maximum value because it's an inverted U. So at also a particular value of X. So now, that is why I say at turning point, this is the turning point. At turning point, the Y dS becomes zero. The Y dS becomes zero. So that is why we are equating this to zero in order to find the value. So if the Y dS is zero at turning point, we say 4 minus 2S. So making this the subject of formula is equal to 4. So S equals to 4 over 2, which is 2. So the value of X that will give maximum from here, that get Y maximum, is 2. I hope we have been solving this question now. And it's more than 10 that we have seen. There's no question we will solve in CHAMP now because we have treated like 3 years now. There's no question. Well, thank you, drone. Aquatic drone. God bless you. There's no question we will solve now that we have not seen. That is why I advise those people that are going for JAMA, West Africa Senior Secondary School examination, certificate examination, to lay their hand on past question. So by the time you solve several questions, you just find out that they are having the same pattern of question. It's the value that are different. So, are you getting the flow? I hope you are getting the flow. So now, the next question. There's no question we will see now that we have not solved. So we are just solving it so that we get ourselves familiar to it whenever we see the question. So that is how we roll. So the question here is, the distance traveled by a particle. So I'm not going to write it. I will just write the equation. Just hear the question. The question says that the distance traveled by a particle from a fixed point is given as S is equal to t raised to power 3 plus t raised to power 2 minus t plus 5. Are you getting it? Find the minimum distance that the particle can cover from the fixed point. Minimum distance. That the particle can cover from a fixed point. So this is the question. So you see this question here, we are still going to solve it the same way we solved the other one. So we are giving this. They are still asking minimum. Whether minimum or maximum, you should follow the same procedure. Are you getting me now? So your value will tell you which one will give you. Like now, you know, when we solve we only have one question. We only have one answer. Be it they ask you minimum, that is the answer. Be it that they ask you the maximum, that is the answer. But in a case whereby we are not having two values, how do you not know the minimum value of Y and the maximum value of Y? It's just the value you got, just substitute it back to the equation you are giving. So the one that gives you the highest value, it is that value of S that will give you the value of Y. So the one that gives you the minimum value of Y, it is that value of X that will give the minimum. So now, let's differentiate this. We are differentiating this now. We have S equals to T cube plus T square minus T plus 5. Are you seeing now? So now, if you find the S dT will now be equal to, when you differentiate, it become 3T square plus 2, differentiate this, 2T minus, this one will give you 1, while this one is 0. So at turning point, this becomes 0 equals to 3t squared plus 2t minus 1. Now, what two number you multiply? Two number you multiply to get 1 times minus 3 times minus 1 minus 3. You have minus 3. By the time you add it, you have plus 2. So we can use minus 3 and 1. No, plus 3 and minus 1. So minus 3 times minus 1 minus 3. 3 minus 1 will give you plus 2. So we can use 3 and minus 1 to split the center value. So what we have here now will now be 0 equals to 3t squared. Instead of writing 2, we are replacing it with 3t minus t. 3t minus t will still give you 2t. So minus 1. So you group them 2 by 2. 3 is here, 3 is here, t is here, t is here. So what they have in common is 3t. So after you have taken 3t here, this one is left with 1t. After you have taken t from here, 3t from here, what we have less here is 1. So into, this is negative, what is common between t and 1 is 1. Then into t plus 1. Because if you say plus, by the time you use this negative to open this bracket, you are going to get positive if you put negative here. And you must have the same value in the bracket. That will tell you that you are correct. You join the one outside. So 0 equals to 3t minus 1 and t plus 1. You get it? So we cannot say 3t minus 1 equals to 0 or t plus 1 equals to 0. So we can say 3t equals to minus 1 or t equals to minus 1. So, no, t equals to plus 1 rather. So we cannot say, therefore, t equals to 1 over 3 when you divide through by 3. 1 over 3. Or t equals to minus 1. Now, here, you will now go back to the question. Now that you have gotten the answer. Now that you have gotten the answer here. Now, what you need to do now, you can't say which one can give you the maximum. They say you should find minimum. You see now, what is the minimum distance? What is this distance? They are looking for minimum distance. So, how do you now get minimum distance from what you have gotten? You need to carry these two. Put 1. When t is equal to 1 here, you write the value down. You put when t equals to 1 over 3, you put the value here. So, the one that gives you the least value, that is what is going to give you the answer. That is the answer you pick here. So, no, okay, now, that is the answer you pick for S. So, let's try it out. When S is 1, when S is minus 1, so what do we have? As in, when T is minus 1. So, minus 1 raised to power 3 plus minus 1 raised to power 2 minus into minus 1, then plus 5. So, what would this one give us? This will give us minus 1 plus 1 plus 1. Plus 5. So this one give us 6. This cancel this. So this one gives us 6. Now let's see 1 over 3. So let's input 1 over 3. I believe I are clear here now. Okay. Let's put 1 over 3. So when t is 1 over 3. When t is 1 over 3. So we'll be having this 1 over 3. 1 over 3. 1 over 3 all cube plus 1 over 3 is there minus, okay, 1 over 3 all square minus 1 over 3 plus 5. So this will give 1 over 27 plus 1 over 9 minus 1 over 3 plus 5. So when you find the LCM, the LCM is 27. So 27, 1 plus 27, 9, 27, that is 3. Times 1 minus 3 27 9 times 1 9 plus 5 27 times 5 27 times 5 that is 5 3 10 13 135. So 135. So let's sum it together. Let's see this one that will give us the minimum and the maximum. So we're having this is 4 minus 5 minus that is 130. 130 over 27. 130 over 27. Because these two will give you 4. 4 minus 9 minus 5. minus 5 plus 135. So let's see our calculator. 130 divided by 27. So the answer is 4.8. So which one gives you the minimum value? Is it 1 over 3 or minus 1? Which one give you the minimum value? Is it 1 over 3 or minus 1? I need your response in the comment section. Which one give you minimum distance? Which one give you minimum? Look at the value now. See, minus 1 gave us 4. 1 over 3 gave us 4.8. Which one is now the minimum? When we substituted for minus 1, this distance is 6. And when we substituted from 1 over 3, the distance is 4.8. So that is where many people will make mistake. They will think that, quite alright, minus 1 is smaller than 1 over 3. Minus 1 is smaller than 1 over 3. That is, 1 over 3 is greater than minus 1. But you will not use that eye to judge it. You need to go and substitute the value. The value will tell you which is the minimum of maximum. So the one that will give you maximum value of y now is 1 over 3. Minimum distance is 1 over 3. Minimum distance will give you 1 over 3. Because when we substituted it, we have 4.8. But when we did for minus 1, we have 6. So that is how you wrote. So evaluate 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 integral of sec square theta d theta. This one is part of the formula I say you should memorize then. No? It's part of it. So, is there anyone who want to drop the answer? So this one, there is a proving, but if you don't need this kind of, you don't need to go and solve. If you want to solve, that will take the whole time from your hand. So all the, something like this, you memorize them. All these simple ones, you use, you memorize them. The answer will give you sec theta tan theta plus c. So when you integrate sec square theta, you have this. I believe you know that from children identity that sec is 1 over cos. I hope you believe. So if that is the case, this will be 1 over cos square theta. This is where they started from. They now use a quotient rule or division rule, it's quotient rule from by integration. You know, if you use differentiation rather, so there is a formula you use, or even we can also apply integration. So you have to just say let u equals to this, and from there you begin the battery. So, but nevertheless, this is just the result. You are. That is how we roll. Let's go to the next one. This and number of students. Number of this and number of students. So this is what we have. We have 120, 2 2x 360 440 5x and 650. So this is the table. The question now says that listen to the question. The question now says that the question says the distribution above shows the number of days a group of 260 students. So this is telling you the total number of students that the analysis was carried out. You got it, flu. Yeah. I got you in the building. Let's go. So let's go now. So now the question is, a group of 260 students were absent from school in a particular term. How many students were absent for at least 4 days in the terms? At least 4 days. At least the guy I know, my friend I know, they don't have time, man. So at least 4 days. Before you can do at least 4 days, you know, you need to calculate the value of x. So that is why you decide these days. I hope you know the difference between at least and at most. At least and at most. At least is, that is where you are going to start your journey ahead. That is the meaning of at least. You are starting the journey ahead from that point. But at most, saying that you are stopping all your journey from where you are, wherever you are coming from, you are stopping at that point. You should not exceed that point. So that is the meaning of at least. Yes, at least is the starting point, while at most is the end point. Thank you for the word. God bless you. Now, how do we calculate this? Since we know the total, we sum this up equals to the total number of what? Of students. Isn't it straightforward, right? We say 20 plus 2s plus 60 plus 10 plus s plus 50 is equal to 260. So from the question, we are given the number, the group of students, the number of students that they are carrying this analysis on. So 20, 60, 80 plus 10, 90, 140. So we have 140. 2 plus 1, 3 plus 3x is equal to 260. So we collect terms. We have 260 minus 140. So 3x will be equal to 0, 2, 1, 120. S equals to 120 divided by 3. So S is equal to 40. So if S is 40, this place, the value here will be 80. And the value here will be, the value here will be 40. Number of students here is 40. Now the question is now that what is the minimum, that is, they are saying the least value. When, how many students are absent when they have the least value of 4? Are you getting me? Let me read the question. The question says, how many students were absent for at least 4 days? At least 4 days. So which means this is 4 days here. From here upward, that is what you are going to add. That is that at least. Having been said, at most 4, we add from here, at most, this is at most. You add everything. And why this is at least? So then, so the answer now will now be equal to from 4 upward. That is 10 plus 40 plus 50. That is 100 students. 100 students were absent. I see you, user. Sophia in the building. Your facial, your shooter, you got those. You are just coming in. I got you in the building. I got you. Today we saw by 12:30. Got you in the building. So we are having this question here. Question of Parshat. Is jam we are doing. We need do jam with the sub jam. You have come across it now. Sorry, I didn't add it well. I did not tell me. We say S is 40. And under 4, we have 40. Under 5, we have 40. Which is X? We have 40. Under 6, we have 50. It's going to be 40 plus 40. Plus 50. That is 130. Don't let us. Is it 130? Let me look at the question again. 440. Okay. And 50. At least. So I hope you. The one I wrote 100 is 100. Is it? So the next having is we're having orange. Orange is occupying 100 degree. We have orange. Apple is occupying S degree. Apple. Purple is occupying 115 degree. Purple. Banana is occupied 100 degree. Banana. So the question is it 100? Let me look at it again. What is our final answer? We said 20 plus 2s plus 60 plus 40 plus x is equal to 50. 20, 80 plus 20, 40. I did not add it well the other time. We have 20, 2x, 60, 40, x, 50, plus 50. It's equal to 260. It's equal to 260. Now, 20 plus 80 plus this, 120. 120 plus 50, 170. I did not write the correct this thing. S and S, 3S. It's equal to 260. 3S will now be 260 minus 170. So 3X will be equal to 0, 16, 9. So S will be equal to 9 over 3, which is 330. So I didn't feel in this thing well the other time. So I didn't feel it well. So that is why. You see it's 60. 60, 40, and things like that. So now, if that is the case, for at least is the 3, 1, 2, 3. That is 4, 5, 6. At least 4. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they say at least. So at least we start from here. So which is 40, the final answer, at least absent for 4 days. 40 plus X is 30, plus 50. So this is 80, 70, so 120. I hope you got it flow. So it's 120. So now, this other one, this is a pie chart. call it pie. Pie, pie. Call it pie. Pie, pie. The question is, the pie chart above represents 400 fruits on display. 400, that is the total fruit. 400 fruits on display. The question says, what are we looking for? We have to find how many apples are in the store. How many apples are in the store? So we want to know, this is the total banana, purple, apple, orange. All of them together in the store is 400. We need to calculate what is now the number of apple in this total fruit. How do you... Mama Nafsi, good morning, ma. How was today, oh? I hope you are fine. Mama Nafsi is the beauty. My big sister is in the beauty. God bless you. So I find the time to be here. You're welcome, ma. So now, how do we know the number of orange here? You need to calculate the angle here first. How do you do that? You know the total summation of all angles in a circle is 360. So you sum all of them up. S degree plus 115 degree plus 100 degree plus... are we having... Let me check the question. Are we having 200? 100. Okay, we're having 100 and 100. 100 degree then plus 1, 2, 3, 4. Equals to 360. We call it angle at the point or sum of angle in a circle is equals to 360. So we have 200 plus this, that is 315 plus 315 is equals to 360. That is 200 plus 100, 300 plus 15, 315. So you collect terms, that is 360 minus 315. So S will be equals to 554. Isn't it 45? No, not 45. Yes, this plus this. So 45. S is 45 degree. So apple is occupying for my is fine, ma. I'm a lousy man. Fine, 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 fine. Today I came home early, very early today. I left work around after four. So I got home early. So now, how do you know the number of apple? Apple in the building is going to be the ratio of the angle that S is covering over total angle multiplied by total apple. So S is covering, that is, apple is covering 45 degree. At what ratio? What is the total angle that is taking part of? If my life cut off, just know my MB has finished. I'm already getting notification. So we'll start another day. 45, 315, what else? 34, 35, what else? 41, 4 here, 1. 100 times 5. Ah, I see 100. 100 times 5, that's 500. You have to divide well, not like this. Let me use calculator. It's like I didn't divide well. Don't mind me. There, okay, this is 40 rather. I've taken away. We are now left with apple. Apple is 5 times 40. And that will give you 0.20. So, only apple is taking 200. It's 0.20. So, that is how they roll. Let me use calculator. Let's confirm. 45 times 400 divided by 360. It's 50. What can I divide? I divide rubbish. I wonder. So guys, I wonder what I use my hand to divide. The answer is 50. So let me try again. 45 over 360 times 400. That's what I did. So the answer is 50. By calculator, let's see. 0, 0, 3 here, 1, 3 here, 2, 3 here, 1 in 15, 5. Okay, I think this is where I made the miss on. 3 here, 4. 3 here, 5. 4 here, 1. 4 here, 10. Okay, 1. So it's 5, 5 times 10. So I hope you got the flow. Thank you, Jerry. Thank you, Mama. Thank you, Mama. So the answer is 50. So we're having 50 apple in if you are calculating, so yeah, somebody, how many orange? Drop the answer. How many orange do we have in 400 fruits? Drop your answer in the comment section. Let's see. Fastest finger. Let's go. How many orange do we have? This is orange. How many orange do we have? Drop the answer in the comment section. You got it. Yeah. Let's go. My auntie is giving me energy. I'm weak before. But because I saw Mama Namsi here in the building, I got the energy. 1-1 orange. This is long month says 1-1-1 orange. Yes. Who else? Who want to try? Got you. Who want to try? Yeah, yes, oh, Mama. I see you, I got energy. So you can't have 0.1 orange now. Just approximate the whole number. It's 1-1. That is 100 over 360 times 400. That will give you the answer. That is how we roll. There's a draft question here. I can't draw graph. So here is the question. We have 5, 8, 6 and K with frequencies 3, 3, 2, 4, and 1 respectively. The question is now saying, and this is and have a mean of 5.7. What is the question? Find the value of K. You know, so with this type of question, the only way you can solve it is to use the mean formula. What is mean? Mean says that total number divided by number of appearances. Total number divided by number of appearances. So the question says 5 appear 3 times. That is the meaning of with frequencies this. 5 appear 3 times. 8 appears 2 times. 6 appear 4 times. And K appear 1 time. So the fastest way to do this is to say no mean is the total. 5 into 3 plus 8 into 2 plus 6 into 4 plus K into 1 divided by how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. That is 4 times. 4 will be equal to 5.7. This is the mean. This is how you calculate your mean. So we have 15 plus 16 plus 24 plus K. 5 times 3, 2 times 8 times 2, 6 times 4, k times 1 will be equals to 4.7 times 4. So at the end of the day, this and this will give us 31. 31, so this one will give us 55. So plus k is equals to, you do this, this is 22.88. Let me see if I'm right. 22.88. That is 5.7 times 4. So I'm right. 22.88. So 22.88. So you make k the subject of formula. Make k the subject of formula. No, this is going to be addition. Sorry. It's going to be total frequency. So it's going to be 3 plus 2 plus 4 plus 1. Since you are multiplying this and this together. How do you mean we are just adding this together? That is where you will use 1, 2, 3, 4 to divide. Well, because we are multiplying this and this, so it's going to be the total divided by total frequency. Remember that your mean is equals to summation fx over summation f. You see, that's what I'm doing. We have our frequencies, which is f, and we have our x. That is why we are doing this time this. This means addition. So this is what we have given. From the question, we have been given the mean, which is 5.5. And you know we have the other one, just that they kept one of the numbers. So that is what we want to calculate. So 3 plus 2, 5 plus 4, 9 plus 1, 10. So this is supposed to be 10. This is supposed to be 10. So 10 times, we change this one to 10. So this one becomes 57. 57. So then you make k the subject of formula. So k will be 57 minus 55. So k equals to 2. So that is how we roll. I hope you got it. K is 2. I hope you got it. That is how we roll. In the building. I hope you got it. God, your face show. Your shoe shine. You got those. Face show. Your shoe shine. You got those. You should finish this year. So we may just... How many questions? We're having 5 questions left. We call it a day. Now, fifth to the last. It says that in how many ways can a delegate? So I'm not going to write this, but I will just write the data given. Just listen to the question. Listen to the question. So listen to the question. So we're having, in how many ways can a delegate of three, be chosen from 5 men and 3 women. 5 men and 3 women. If at least one man and one woman must be included. You have the question. You get the question. The question is saying that they want to pick delegates, and these delegates must be 3. Are you getting me? It's like in a group of people, maybe in a class. They want to choose class captain. So they are not giving restriction. They are giving you the let me say what that needs to guide you. How do you choose your maybe captain? So, and they need, let's say they need three captains in a class. So now, if there are, they need three captains in the class, you know, you have total number of boys or man or total number of girls, or you call them woman. So are you getting it now? Now, you know, you can choose them anyhow you like. But now we have been given boundary. This is the boundary here. So having made this question just stop here, we have another way to it. Now the question moves further. The boundary given is that at least this one, they don't want to know how you are going to do it. In this delegate, in this choosing of class captain, you must have a girl and a boy. So whatever that you like, go and do with the remaining person. If you like, you know, we're having two options there now. So if one, the first option is this. If one man must present, it means that there is every tendency that we can have two women. And then the second assumption is this. If one woman must be there, so there is every tendency that two men will be in the committee or will be chosen as class captain. So let's now use that analogy now to answer this question. They said delegates, they are to choose three delegates. So and they are going to be choosing from five men. That is the total number of men in the place. We also having three women. That is the total. Now, and out of these five and these three, you need one of them must be present into three. So which means the option, the committee to be formed, we must have a total of three. The committee to be formed, we must have a total of three. So now, in the first option, where we are having one man and two women. This is the first option, that we're having one man and two women. So how do you now write it? Because the order is not necessary. You know, the difference between permutation and combination is, I hope I'm not missing it. If the order of selection is not necessary, then it's combination. But if the order of selection is necessary, you call it permutation. So now here, if you like, pick two first. If you like, pick one. But we're having two as option. So this one is showing us that we are having five men. It becomes five combination one multiplied by two women. But the total women in the place is three. That is three combination two. My brother and my sister. If you add one and two, how many is that? Oh, play with. Ah, Twalisa. Sean. Twa. Hey, I can't even say they should grab. God bless you. God bless you, sir. So, I see you. Thanks for yesterday. Sir. I see you too. God bless you. I really appreciate you, sir. So, you see this now. So, this is what we are having. If you have one and two, that will give you three. So, you have formed first assumption. Oh, thank you, sir. I really appreciate you, sir. So, we already have three. Three as four. So, the second option is this. So, this is the second option. The second option we are having. So, the second option is this. So, since we are in first option, we have said that one man, two women. So, there's every probability, every possible that we can also have two men, and one woman. You know, the possibility you can have cannot pass these two. Why? Because of this restriction that one person from the different don't worry. Once I remember, I will use it. We must pick a gender. There's a gender mix. You must not have a single gender, just one place. There is going to be a gender mix, which means you will not have, the assumption must not pass these two. The assumption must not pass. Is it that you have one man and two women making three, or two men, one woman? So they are still making three. So now you are not having. How do you solve this? How do you solve this? It becomes 5 factorial because it's combination over 5 minus 1 factorial, then 1 factorial, 1 factorial, then plus 3 factorial over 3 minus 2 factorial, 2 factorial. So we cannot say 5 factorial over 4 factorial times 1 factorial, then plus 3 factorial over 2 minus 3 minus 1. That is 1 factorial, 2 factorial. So I'm going to expand this. I'll stop at 4 factorial because there's 4 factorial here. So 5 times 4 factorial will stop because I'm having 4 factorial here. In order to 1 factorial is 1. In order to make the work faster, then plus 3 times 2 factorial because I'm having 2 factorial in the denominator. I will stop there. So I will have 1 factorial is 1 multiplied by 2 factorial. So 4 factorial cancel 4 factorial. 4 factorial cancel 4 factorial. Then 4 factorial, 4 factorial. Then 2 cancel 2. So what you are having here is 5 times 3, and that will give you 15. So it's for this. I've not written the formula for this one. So let's solve that one now. I hope you are getting it. So let's solve it. So I just solve for this now, and the answer is 15. So we need to solve for this one. So we need to solve for this. So now, in this second option, we are having 5 out of 2, which is, we are selecting 2 out of 3 committee. Then multiply by, you know, women is 3, and now they are now 1. So if you still sum this one, if you sum this one, we'll give you 3. If you sum this one, we'll give you 3. So that is a total number of delegates. So let's solve this. 5 factorial over 5 minus 2 factorial, 2 factorial. Multiply by 3 factorial over 3 minus 1 factorial, 1 factorial. So this one becomes 5 factorial over 3 factorial. That is 5 minus 2. Then 2 factorial. Then multiply by 3 factorial over 2 factorial, 1 factorial. So I'm going to stop at 3 because I'm having 3 factorial down. So 5 times 4 times 3 factorial over 3 factorial. And 2 factorial is 2 times 1. So 3 factorial cancel 3. 2 here, 1. 2 here, that gives 2. 5 times 2, that is 10. So let's keep that one. So let's solve for this. This one will give us, I'm going to stop at 2 because there's 2 factorial at the denominator. 3 times 2 factorial, then over 2 factorial, 1 factorial is 1. So 2 factorial cancel 2 factorial. We are left with 3. Right? This, we are left with 3. So it becomes times 3, which is 30. So the total committee, say how many ways can this be chosen? It's going to be 30 plus 15. The initial one we got, 30 plus 15, that is 45 ways. Is that clear? Do we get that? Okay. Let's go. I got you in the building. So the next one here is, how many ways? This one too is how many ways can 9 people be seated if 3 chairs are available? In how many ways can 9 people be seated if there are only 3 shares, let me see. If 3 shares are available, so I think I'm already adding my own English. If 3 shares is available. I'm available. If three shares are available. You got it, Flo. Can we solve it now? You got it, Flo. Let's go. 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 Should I solve or wait? Solve or wait. Okay, let's solve. Now, let's understand the question. The question says that, in how many ways can 9 people be seated if 3 shares are available? Look at me. Let's assume we are 9. I'm the first person at the front. The second person, third person, fourth person, fifth person, sixth person, seventh person, eighth person, ninth person. Are you getting me now? So all of them are at my back. And there are now 3 shares available at my front. Now, how many chances do I have to sit? How many chances do I have? I want it in the comment section. How many chances do I have? You know, we're having 9 people, which including me. 8 people at my back, including me, making 9. And 3 shares is available for me. So, how many chances do I have? Drop it in the comment section. 1 over 3 chances. Think about it, too. Remember that I'm the only one at the front, too. Nobody is fighting with me. I have the luxury to choose anyone I like. So, let me say it this way. We can say, with the way I explain it well. I can say 3. 3 is correct, the way you are saying it. But 3 is not the answer. Now, let us say that, because, you see, the question did not tell us if they line up at each other's back. They didn't tell us if they are on queue. Now, if they are not on queue, what if the nine of us, now we are now on side by side to each other, and 3 seats is now available at the front. Now, the first person, all of us, how many chances do all of us have? If you look at it, let me put it that way. Look at the scenario. We're having 3 shares here. And we're having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. So, you can see something now. Now, out of this 9 that is here, and 3 shares are available, which means this person entitled to it. This person is entitled to any of the share. Any of the 9 people here, the first person, which means out of the 9, everybody is entitled. That is 9. That is 9 position. We are having 9. Are you getting me now? The nine is telling us that everybody there, they have the opportunity to sit on any of it. 1. Now, if this one has been, they have sitting on this, so which means How many chances do we have? How many spaces do we have left? It's two. So which means, let's say, the person at position 5 has taken one seat. Maybe, you know, you remember this game. They will be singing that. You will be listening, you know, that when they stop, where the first to sit wins the game. They will be singing. That is what it's like. That is what they are doing for them. So they are singing for them. They now drop 3 shares. So, you know, it's only 3 people that will have chance to sit. So, and it's going to be it's going to be the 9th person, the 8th person, and the 7th person. That is what I just want to explain. So, if this one person has taken one seat, and there's every opportunity that all the 9, any of them can sit, that is why we're having 9. The next one is that the remaining 8 people, there's any opportunity that any of them can sit. So, there are 8 spaces to fight for 2. So, to fight for 2 position. So, we're having it. So, the remaining one, let's say, is the 9th person that sits. Now, this remaining one, the remaining 7, they have to fight for it. Fight to the core. Beat anybody to stupor. Let me use the Brashagi language. So, they beat anybody to stupor to sit on this last seat. So, which means it's only 7 people that remain to fight for this one seat. So, which means that is 7 chances to just fight for the only this. And once one of the person has no sitting on this, that is all. There's no more space for them, man. So the remaining one. Oh, yeah, I beg you to build it. Yeah, I beg you, I got you to build it. God bless you. God bless you. It's been a long time. I saw you on live. You said this, Sha. You don't normally come on live. How you doing, man? How are the children? Yes, so Clemas G. Thank you. God bless you. Yeah, baby. How is study? I know it's not easy. You're learning. I know it's not easy. No children copy with study. You are trying. Oh, God bless you. I see you. T-Boss in the building. See you. God bless you. God bless you. Good evening, ma. Yes, that is our amiable moderator. Ayomi in the building. So now the answer is this times this time is equal to this. That is 72 times 7. 72 times 7. 14, 1. 49, 50. So 405 ways. It's going to be 405 ways. I hope the story is clear. I hope the story is clear. Yes, so this is a jam question. But nevertheless, they can see this question in white. You can just the WhatsApp link is on my bio. You can join from here, drop it in the group. We have an amazing people in the group. We have a WhatsApp group. Just join. You will see a WhatsApp link from my bio. You can drop the question. Why not now? It's the movement now. It's movement. If I see any opportunity, I will grab it like this. Bam! We are moving. We are moving. No? I have like 6 people that I help with mathematics. We have some in Canada, some in USA, and some in Chicago. So we are just looking for we are looking for a link to pick the race. It's the link we are looking for. It's the link we are looking for. So I hope I'm correct with my multiplication. 9 times 8 times 7. 9 times 8 times 7. Okay, 5 over. 5 over. This is correct. 5 over. It's correct. 5 over is correct. Nigeria will do a lot now. This one I'm doing now. I'm not doing it in a class or in school now. I'm doing this in my home, in my room. So definitely anywhere I am, I still continue my online battle. So everybody can still enjoy it. So that doesn't mean it will just give me a better, let me say, a better life. At least, look at the way I'm using Mac and things like that. I know there are electronics that I can use instead of writing, cleaning. So I will just be pressing the button. It will even make the teaching easier. You got it? To make the teaching easier. So I won't be writing, cleaning. So there are questions, I don't copy everything. So I just copy part of it. But if this thing is electronic, then I'll just paste it. Solve, press button, wipe it off, I can just use hand. I've seen a lot of people, I've seen someone using that gadget. But you know, a step at a time. And we are going to get there. So drop your question, T-Boss. I've told him to follow the link in my bio. There is a group. You can drop the question there. I will see the question and I will solve it. Even I have people in the building, in the group. Once you drop any question, they even before I even surface, they solve it. So we have an amazing group. You got it. So let's see. I think that is okay. Which one? We have another one here. This one, I'm not going to write it. Don't listen. But I'll write out the details given. Listen to the question. The question says that the probability of a student passing any examination, probability of pass is 2 over 3. That is what the question says. Now, the probability of a student passing any examination is 2 over 3. If the student takes three exams, what is the probability that he will not pass any of them? These people, they are not nice. So, if the probability of passing just an exam is 2 over 3, now, and this person took the exam, he took total exam sitting for, is 3. Total sitting is 3. And the announcer says that you should find the probability that it is the person is going to fail all of them. So no single pass. So if he's going to fail all of them, and you must know that probability cannot be greater than 1 or lesser than 0. Probability between 0 and 1. 0 and 1. And for you to have probability to be 1, it means that is there a situation you can have probability that is 1? It's like, it's only God. When God say like, by tomorrow, at exact this time, rain is going to fall. Are you getting me now? That is a very assurance level. Very assurance level. But you see, between, we can guess. Okay, the probability, we can get by times and season. Okay, maybe by this time, next year, or by this time, rain, we are going to be having rain period. That time, we are not guessing, your value will be dangling between 0 and 1. So now, if this person, the probability that is going to pass is this, we can as well find probability that not pass. So probability not pass, it will be 1 over, because the total probability you can have is 1. So, if you have known the probability that somebody will not pass, you know, pass, either you pass or you fail. So, when you add it together, it should give you 1. So, that is what we want to do here. So, 2 over 3. So, and that will give you 3. 1 in 3. 3. 3 times 1. 3. Minus 3 in 3. 1 times 2. 2. So, the probability that this person will fail is 1 over 3. The probability that this person will fail is 1 over 3. Now, if the probability that is going to fail is 1 over 3, you take the first exam, fail, second exam, fail, third exam, fail. What do we have? It's going to be probability of fail, fail, fail. And if that is the case, faith 1 over 3. Faith 1 over 3. Hey, network. I hope my flow. Repeat or continue. Repeat or continue. You get a flow. Then you get a flow. Flow, flow, flow. Then you get a flow, 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 flow. Flow, 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 flow. This is the last question here. Do you get the flow, 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 flow? Flow, 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 flow. Flow, 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 flow. Hey, seems my network works well. Should I repeat this last level? Should I repeat this one? So I say the probability of not pass is 1 over 3. But I say 1 minus the probability of pass, which is this. So the person now took the exam 3 times. So and is failing it. First time fail, second time fail, third time fail. Fail 1 over 3 times 1 over 3 times 1 over 3, which is 1 over 27. So the last question here. The last question here. The last question here is this. So since this is the last question, I'm going to draw the table. We are having a table for this. The table is marks. The table is marks and number of students. So the table is marks and number of students. Number of students. So if the table is marked and number of students, we have 2 has 3 students, 3 has 4 students, 4 have 1 student, 5 has 0, 6 has 4, 7 has 5, 8 has 2, 9 has 1. These jam people, they are going for jam. You have to practice and practice and practice so that you will get yourself familiar with some questions. Jam questions take, you are meant to use like 40. I think I've calculated that. I put that on my YouTube page. You have like 40 seconds to answer one question. And you look at, see the question we have been answering since morning. Some questions say may take 10 minutes of our time. But because I'm explaining it, even if I want to even do it, sometimes there are some questions that will take me 2 minutes, even if I'm in exam hall. So, but by the time you familiarize yourself, solve, and all of the subjects you are sitting for, not only math, you just have to program yourself during the week. With this from maybe Monday, Tuesday, this subject, and you don't change from it. Once you get to that day, you have to read that particular subject. You have to just time yourself and ensure you touch all the past question. So by the time you read them over and over again, some question exam work, you will not need to even calculate. You have already know. Your instinct will just give you the answer and you will be very sure of it. So that is why I'm shouting on this. So the question now is now that the table above show the distribution of marks student in a test. This is the marks student in a test. We have them, the number of students that score 2 marks, number of students that score 3 marks, up to 9 marks. We only have 1 student that score 9 marks. So now the question is, find the probability of passing the test. Probability of passing the test. If the pass mark is 5, probability of passing this test. If the pass mark is, what did they say? If the pass mark is... Okay, if the pass mark is 5, this one now is what? This is another way of saying the at least for you to pass at least 5 mark is the same thing. And that they say for you to pass is you must score at least 5 mark, or what is the total number of students, the probability if the pass mark is what? If the pass mark
is 5. Now, you know probability. You must know the formula for probability. You have some textbooks, you have it in a different way. You have chances over total chances. Total chances. You also have some other, but this is just it. So, your focusing point divided by the total, divided by your sample. Are you getting me now? So, now let's go. What are our chances? Our chances are, if the pass mark is 5, that you must have from 5. Okay, if the pass mark is 5, you see, and 5 starts from here. So you have to add all this one. It's going to be 0 plus 4 plus 5 plus 2 plus 1. 9, 11, 12. 9, 11, 12. 9, 11, 12. Are you seeing now? So now, if that is the case now, that we have no, this is our focus point, because the pass mark must be what? 5. And why are we adding this? We are adding the number of students that pass the test. That is why it's not mark we are dealing with now. Mark is just giving us the edge where we are to start from. So if the people that are that score 5 are the ones that pass, then from 5 downward, they are the ones that fail. And that is what the probability says we should calculate if the passing mark is 5. If the pass mark is at least 5, then we should. If the passing the test, the probability of passing the test, if the pass mark is a probability of passing the test, if the pass mark is 5. So now, what is now our total chances? Total chances is now the total number of students in the school or that took the test. So from here to here is 12. I'll just say 12 plus 1 plus 4 plus 3. So which is equals to 7, 8, 20. So the probability that pass mark is 5 will be equals to chances is 12 over total chances 20. 4 here 3, 4 here 5. So the probability is 3 over 5. Is that clear? Is that clear? Is that clear? If it's clear, we call it a day. I got you, Langma. I got you in the building. We shall meet tomorrow again. Thank you, guys. Drop your question in the comment section. Let me go and look for trouble. Let me go and look for somebody that will beat me to stupor. Somebody that will beat me to stupor. This person that will be beating me, I'm looking for now. Emmy baby. MGB. Let's see if this one's going to. Good Hello. Morning. Hi, how you doing?
I'm fine.
Good morning, morning, morning. First thing first, I gave you a follow.
Yeah, I followed you back.
Nice. I see you in the beauty. This your face is very sharp. Oh. It's not showing sleeping at all. Have you slept during the day? Jesus. It's like you have slept during the day.
No, I didn't sleep. I've not slept, though. I hardly sleep at night. Steven Skillful, welcome. Is that probability on the board?
I just finished teaching.
Probability, yes. Right?
Yes. It's time for us to do follow. You got the flow.
when we do the hard part, we enjoy ourselves too. You have to make ourselves happy.
Okay, chances of our total chances is because
yes,
you know, so, this probability thing used to give me headache in secondary school.
You are no longer doing it now.
No, I'm done now. I'm done with school. So.
I know. You just got the brain, still recall. That is awesome.
Yes, now.
It's like you are a science student.
Yes, I am.
Because I hardly see a lady say yes now. I say, hey, what is this? Some people, once I co-host there, I say, hey, what is this? So you, you were just feeling like, what is it? It's good.
It's my chop favorite knuckle. Subject.
Chop knuckle, hey, for the first time. Oh, come and beat me now. Let beat me so that I will carry that one to go and sleep.
You have gifters, they will beat me.
I have gifter. Well, everybody, yeah. My viewer, anybody, all of them, they are my gifter.
Guys,
yes, so,
you can hear
me. Everybody,
me,
I know. With viewer, whether gifter or no gifter, all of them are my gifter. Whether you tap your screen, you are my gifter. You don't tap your screen, you are my gifter. I got you. That is the level of putting my viewer. You got it. Nobody should be feeling down that, hey, I'm not gifting. They are just calling that man alone. You got the flow. Everybody get the dunes. Their face show. Their shoes shine. And they got the dunes. That is how we roll.
Yes, that's how we roll.
That is how we roll.
Eddie Paco, well, thank you.
Josh, I see you in the building.
Eddie Paco.
Kind of part of, I got you.
Welcome. Don Chris, welcome.
Yes, so,
welcome.
What do you mean?
Baby girl, I got you. I see you. Don't think I'm not seeing you.
You really try today, what do you mean?
That's Kate.
You were here since morning.
Eddie Paco, thank
you.
Thank
in the
you,
afternoon.
Tap on your screen for me.
God bless you.
Tap on your screen.
Guys, we can do this.
Statistics, welcome. Tony, welcome. Please stop for your
We do this. Let's go.
Kate,
let's go.
Kate,
let's go.
For me now, please. Actually, no, please,
I need to. I'm going to scour this place with dance today. Time to dance.
You want to dance?
Time to dance. Time to do the try to do the dance. You're gonna see something. Table, go and sit one place. Table, go and sit one place. Time to dance.
Please stop on your screen for me. So
time
you want
to
dance?
Yes,
now. Math teachers are not supposed to dance.
I'm not a math teacher. I just love math.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Let me mirror this thing. Let's see the flow. Now the flow.
Let's see
the moves. Yeah. Let's see the moves.
Let's
go.
Don't
please
thank you, guys. Guys, please stop on your screen for me. So he wants
let's
to
go in the building. We got you.
Guys, thank you for this number. Thank you.
See many people there outside with the female dope. Oh no, I mean, I stand
to defend. Welcome,
welcome.
Said
she wanna fix her. Say it, say it. Yeah, they not want it.
I got you, Bob. Thank you. Thank you, Father.
Welcome. Guys, please follow me on my page. I'll follow back. Conan, welcome, Conan. Keep rolling. Welcome, Chick.
I got to be your defender. You don't need to tell me.
Hey, guys, don't go. Welcome.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Thank you. Oh, my friend is good. It's right.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Kevin. In the building, Kevin. In the building, Kevin. In the building, I got you.
Hey, Yowie, we see you. Thank you.
You got it, Flo.
Thank you.
You got it, Flo. Guys, that was Ro. See you in the beauty. Thank you, guys.
That was nice. That was nice. I like your moves. I cannot dance like that, though. Okay, he's entertaining us, actually. So.
Hey!
Cocolette, how are you doing? Hey, I like his energy, guys. Please, let's go and support him. Let's move to his side and support him. Yeah. Yeah, please. Energy is mad. Thank you, Kelvin. Follow him and support. He knows how to support him. I can't do this dance. I've tried it. I'm almost put my teeth on the ground. Please,
oh, it's my God, platinum.
Please, guys, go to Clean Mass page and like his post. Go and support Clean Mass. He's actually entertaining us. I wish I could go there to that. Actually entertaining. Hola, Rotimi. What's up? How are you doing? What do you want? What's up? You want to play the game? Okay, after this fight, we'll go back and play the game. Obaloluwa, welcome, Obaloluwa. God, the king, obviously.
You got a flow. Hello, yes. Hello, good guy.
Abdurashid, welcome, Abdurashid. Guys, thank you so much for your support. Thank you so much. Please tap on your screen for me.
Let's go.
Welcome, tap on your screen for me.
I got you guys. I see you, the beauty. Thank you, thank you. I got you, the beauty.
That was nice.
I need to know how to pronounce it with your name. I'm Babi.
AMG baby. It's AMG baby. Zico, welcome.
I got you in the beauty. Oh, it's my E. I see you.
Kevin
in the beauty. I got you.
Kelvin,
I just gave you a follow. Kevin, I just gave you a follow. I must follow you.
Don't worry, I got you. Leave me, I beg. I don't feel love this night.
I got you.
Welcome, Don Chris.
I see you, Kevin, in the building. Who do we have here? I see you in the building. God bless you. Oh my God, I just gave you a follow. If I see you, kindly follow back. How you doing? I'm doing great. Your face show, your shoe shine, you got those. Your face show, your shoe shine, you got those. Your face show, your shoe shine, you got those. Your face show, your shoe shine, you got those. Your face show, your shoe shine, you got us. Your facial, your shoe shine, you got us. Your facial, your shoe shine, you got us. Your facial, your shoe shine, you got us. You got us. You got us. You got us. You got it. You got it. I see you coming in the building.
Kevin in the building.
See you in the building. God bless you, Kevin.
Okay.
God bless you, Kevin.
Thank you for the support. Seriously, thank you for the support. Like, I really appreciate your support, sincerely.
Yeah, so, so Kevin came from you, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Ah, Kevin. Kevin, I need to play Dorime for you. You deserve Dorime.
Yeah.
Oh no.
Yes, Kevin deserves Dorime. Actually.
Kevin deserves to Dorime.
Magnificent.
I need to do.
Free me.
I need to do that. You deserve Dorime.
Welcome.
You deserve Dorime.
Welcome. Thug, can't thug, chill, Joe. Kobe, welcome. Welcome, oh. Play the Dorime now. Sure, you want to play Dorime for us? It's
been no, Kevin was saying something, but I don't get it. He said I should not play it.
Why? Clumsy.
Kevin, I didn't get that part where he said I should not. No play, oh. Now, waiting the thing.
Play Dorime for us. Let's hear. That song is inspirational. Who knows now? Like, 10 people come and gift me because I want gifts plenty. But, Kelvin, thank you so much. Now, waiting the East drop by 5 million last year. Mama, don't go 4-5.
Where is the
Oh, well, me, I didn't find Lion. No. Please play Dorime. Maybe someone give me Lion or give me a private jet or something. So that you play the song. Let's see how.
Have you seen all these Arabic people mashing? They are crazy in gift. Jesus. Lion, no, you will see like 5 lions.
Lions.
Don't go anywhere.
If you go, you go see me for your dream. If you go, I sit down for you. Don't go anywhere. Don't tell me amazing vibes. Stay there. Buddy Geshi, welcome. Clams, welcome. Play Dorime, please. Let us see who give us Lion like this night. Or give us something we've never seen before. Though Kevin already gave me Duck that I've never seen before. Let him play Dorime for us. Clams, welcome, guys. You've like 2 million times, Kelvin. You know, when you say bye, I'm like, even, you know, everybody knows you. Once you say bye, they're saying a lie. You go see Kelvin for up in your watch.
The picnic teleprompter, I keep my eyes on the camera while
Mr. Campos, welcome, Mr. Campos. Welcome, guys. Please support me. Please, I really appreciate it if you can support me. Clemas, you can't find the song.
It's playing now.
Okay.
I'm going to get you. Mind the beauty. I see you.
I really is fine. It's somewhere in the house. It's not disturbing myself. It's somewhere alone. It's probably sleeping or something.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go.
Life is all about maths. Once you open his life, you'll be teaching people mathematics. Abel's signature, welcome.
Let's go. I got you in the beauty. I got you in the beauty. That is how we roll.
Really don't disturb me. See, yes. Speaking about the death.
That is how we roll.
See, really.
That is how we roll. Catch, why are you disturbing?
You just woke up.
I got you in the beauty. Let's play chicken. Chicken.
I think he heard his name. He heard when I said Rolly. So he came, he woke up immediately. Immediately I said Rolly. He knows his name. Thank you guys. Please tap on your screen for me. I miss Ada, seriously. I'm looking for that gift that is to come when Ada is around. All those big gifts. All those big gifts that is to come when Ada is around. I'm looking for them. Big Eye Connie. Welcome, Big Eye. Welcome, Big Eye Connie.
Hello?
Nah, he doesn't. He hates it. He hates it. He hates the light self, like, but when he wants to disturb you, come and peep. Just say hello. Say hello. Hi. Big Icon, you're welcome. He doesn't like the camera. I don't think he does. I don't think he ever does. World Mimi, welcome, World Mimi. King 55, welcome, King 55. Ijoba 82, welcome Ijoba 82.
Hello? Coming.
Okay, so clean mask. I think I have to go now.
Thank you for your time.
Thank you, I really appreciate it. Yeah, you entertained us. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye. See you another time. Maybe we'll find time and do live match.